So, in the beginning, I would like to let you know that it is one of the oldest form of drying equipment and drying technology. It is very commonly used dryer. As we have discussed in the classification of dryer, with respect to the heat transfer mechanism, it is a convection type dryer. And with respect to the solid handling, here material is agitated. And with respect to dosage form, which can be handled in this dryer, it is used for drying in drying of solutions like liquid or semi-liquid products. One of the few technologies it is available for converting liquid slurry or low viscosity paste to dry free-flowing powder. So let's move to what is the theory of spray drying. This simple diagram you are seeing here, what does that dryer means? The hot dryer is a hot air is introduced. It is a dryer which provides a large surface area for heat and mass transfer by atomizing the liquid to small droplets. So what is the basic principle? We are atomizing the liquid into the small droplet form, providing the high surface area. So that's why the drying is very effective here. Substances to be dried are sprayed into the stream of hot air like this, okay, and so that each droplet dries to a solid particle. So whatever the feed is there, it is moving, and it is in counter current way, it is getting the maximum contact with the hot air, and after drying, it can be collected through the outlet. This drying chamber, what you can see here, this drying chamber resembles the cyclone, ensuring good circulation of air to facilitate heat and mass transfer. And that dried particles are separated by the centrifugal action. This is just the simplest way I can let you know about very briefly in spray drying. Now let us move to advantages of spray drying. It is a continuous process. If heat supply is uninterrupted, it can work for months. Physical properties of products like size, shape, moisture content, flow properties, they can be controlled through equipment choice and process variables. The rapid drying small droplet size with high surface area. Due to this, the actual drying time of a droplet is only a fraction of a second. And the overall time in the dryer is only a few seconds. So that's why it is suitable for many substances which doesn't require high temperature, or which cannot withstand the high temperatures. It is not destructive. The evaporation is very rapid. The droplets do not attain a high temperature, so most of the heat being used as latent heat of vaporization. Other advantages include we can have uniform particle size, free-flowing particles, we can have high bulk density and reduced solubility the product is having, which is spray dried. Porous product we get with the help of spray drying. And the labor and cost-effective process it is. It is very cost-effective and very, with respect to the labor effective, cost is very less here. And it can be fully automated. You can make it fully automated. So, choice is yours. This equipment is very bulky. But the problem is, what are the limitations? That the equipment is very bulky. It can be connected to the accessories, fans, heaters. It is not suitable for producing granules with mean particle size more than 200 micron, because for that you need greater size of the drying chamber, and overall the product is expensive. The product has product needs very high head space. So overall, let's move to uses part. It is suitable for solutions or suspensions, for drying solution suspension, for drying of thermolabile materials. It is suitable for large quantity solutions, okay? Suitable for both soluble and insoluble substances like citric acid, gelatin, starch. It can produce spherical particles in the respiratory range, okay, which can be respired. Dry powder inhalers can be prepared through it. Drying of milk, soap and detergent, you might have enjoyed when you were a kid, and even adults love the, you know, milk powder, because milk powder is a spray-dried product. Wonderful example of household example of spray-dried product. For pharmaceutical products, including APIs and excipients like antibiotics, sulfathiazole, sulfstreptomycin, tetracycline, etc., are spray-dried. Vitamins like ascorbic acid, vitamin B12, enzymes like amylase, protease, trypsins, lipase, and excipients like lactose, mannitol, and microcrystalline cellulose, MCC, etc., are dried with the help of spray-drying technology. Now, let us see that how the spray drying process works. So we are summarizing the spray drying process with the help of this thing. What you can see here, this is the drying chamber, okay? This is the drying chamber, and this is a cyclone separator, okay? And this is the dust collector, okay? Dust collector, cyclone separator, and the spray dryer. And feed is entering here. So let's see one by one the steps involved here. Feed enters into the dryer chamber, okay? Feed is entering here, and that feed is rotated or in the centrifugal atomizer and enters, and the atomization occurs. The hot air enters in the counter current way most of the time, and here the heated air comes into the intimate contact of the feed. Here in the next stage, they are each and every droplet is coming into the contact of the drying air, the hot air, and then the air moves to the outlet. The drying product, the product which have been dried with the help of this motion, with the counter current, spray air contact, the heat has been transferred to the feed, and feed has become dry. Now it falls on this discharge outlet, and with the help of this, you can see here that cool air is going out from the exit, and the product started its journey towards the cyclone separator. Towards the cyclone separator, this feed is moving. Now it enters into the cyclone separator, where the high velocity of air enters. And due to this high velocity of air, what is happening? That high velocity takes the fines with it, and the movement is directed towards the dust collector, as you can see here. Okay, so fines will be taken away by the high velocity air to the dust collector, and then at the last step, we will get the final product, okay, in the discharge outlet of the cyclone separator, and the fines will be collected by the dust collector. This was all about the exact mechanism of spray drying process. Hope you would have enjoyed this processing and this presentation of spray drying process. So try to learn this process quite simple. Now it is looking simple to you now, because we have explained the thing in such a way so that you can learn the thing from your exam point of view. Now let us discuss what was happening in the drying chamber. In the drying chamber, the counter current mechanism, the droplet entered, the feed is entering from here, okay, feed is entering, and atomizer, whatever, say for example, whatever the atomizer you are using, nozzle or any other kind of atomizer you are using, that rotary atomizer or nozzle atomizer, what is happening? It is converting the feed into the droplets, fine droplets. When these fine droplets are coming, they are coming into the intimate contact of the heated air. So drying gas contacts the droplets, and what is happening, the outer crust is dried first, though the moisture may be remaining inside them. In the fractions of seconds, 10 to the power minus 2 seconds, what is happening, the outer crust dries up, and the last part of the, which are in the inner core, the moisture which is remaining here, it pops out in the later stage. This is the reason where we are getting the particles, dried product, which are having porous in nature. Their inner core is hollow. That's why they had got the high bulk density and ready solubility, just due to this. Because at the later stage, what happens, that the moisture which is there inside the core of the droplet, in individual droplet, pops out in the later stages, leaving behind a hollow sphere. So the particle is having, number one, the spherical shape, and number two, they are hollow in nature. Their core is hollow. So that's why they show the ready solubility.